We all have things that tick us off in life. For example, bullies, drugs, and hard to control children. I can ignore all of these things. However, there's one thing that's been bothering me that I can't ignore.
I'm talking about these users my age and up showing their complete lack of thoughtfulness when reviewing a video game.
It's like someone pursuing a PhD but only reads comic books. There are three things that I can't stand. First of all, a few of them don't use a script. I wonder if they have written down any notes at all. Secondly, many of them don't edit the footage in the videos. It's basically footage that occurs as if you turned on the video game console and started to play from start to finish. And the third one is the worst of the worst. I'm sure some folks will object to this complaint. The worst part about these guys is repeated profanity and vulgar actions. Thought so. But let me explain. When you don't script yourself, you sound boring with a lot of uhs, ums, and many pauses. To be more specific, how would you like it if a radio or TV announcer started telling a story and had no idea how he or she would tell it? With all the stammering and time wasting, wouldn't it make you want to change the channel? We usually only get to see the first few levels of the game you're reviewing. That doesn't always show us the troubled points you're describing. Sometimes people watching would want to see the later levels. I certainly would. I don't want to see someone continuously failing to pass a stage or level and having to start over. The third problem, profanity and disgraceful actions, is the number one reason why most game reviewers are hard to enjoy. This problem raises a big question.
Do you absolutely think it is necessary to spew out dirty language and have it bounce off a viewer's eardrums? I mean, think about it for a minute or two. Do you want to know why dirty language is a huge deal? It's mostly because of two important points.
The first point is, the inappropriate words being launched out of your oral cavity like bullets just make you sound quite unintelligent and not even funny in the slightest. Too many reviewers' favorite words are the F words, the A words, and the S word. Those words have basically replaced every possible adjective, noun, and interjection imaginable. I feel as if people are devoted to these words as if they were awesome presidents or prime ministers.
Honestly, guys, can't you think of something better to say or a better way to say it? Swear words are just a crutch! Besides, you should really take this into consideration. It's also the second point I want to make. There are children who use the internet. That's right, I said children.
What if a kid stumbled upon your review and started reciting out loud, "This game is a piece of shit. I can't f***ing stand this f***ing crap anymore. I'm done having a f***ing day." They'll be sent to their room with soap in their kissers, along with a glass of water and a bucket. Don't you realize that when a child hears other people cuss, he or she will think that it's cool? Don't you want to set a better example than that?
Hey kids, guess what? It's alright for you to mimic me, because I have amazing talent. So forget about Fred and Smosh, watch my videos. You'll be cooler than they are. Oh man, I sure don't want to say that again. Whew.
To put it simply, using profanity and vulgarity during a review of a video game is unnecessary. It's also just plain boring. This suggestion is directed towards three reviewers that people seem to pay the most attention to: Chris Bors, the irate gamer, James Rolfe, the angry video game nerd, and Douglas Darian Walker, that guy with the glasses.
I have an idea. Why don't you revise some of your reviews when you get the chance? Sure, it's a truckload of work, but if you do that, you might just end up with more fans. Right now, you might either be throwing a hissy fit or wondering, what would be a good review to watch? Well, luckily, I know four places on the net where civilized behavior is found. Nightwing01's YouTube channel page, Strange Gamer's channel page, GameSpot.com, and GameTrailers.com. That's a total of only four places on the net, and on one hand, where civilized reviews can be found. Think about it.
Who wants to hear a person my age or older shout loudly and curse like a sailor over a video game? Your parents tell you to stop shouting over a game when you're young, and at your age, that info should be hardwired to your cerebrum. Even though you're acting, the cursing is abrasive and tiresome. Let me assure you, I like the work of James Rolfe, Chris Bors, and Douglas Walker. However, there are a few things about those reviewers that make them less enjoyable. Take Mr. Rolfe's work, for instance. He puts his reviews up on three different websites: GameTrailers.com, ScrewAttack.com, and Cinemassacre.com. All reviews I've seen are flooded with swears and common crude phrases. His movie summaries on Cinemassacre.com are similar, except that they are not as loaded with bad language as his AVGN videos. Even if Rolfe is part of an R-rated movie site, there is no need to include things like, "They'll kick your ass till shit comes out your ears." I can understand crude jokes and many swears in an R-rated movie or mature-rated game, since it's authentic for where the action takes place. However, in a game review, not to mention a movie or TV show review, the included vulgarity and profanity is out of line in place. If these guys used their intellect as well as their talent, the audience scale would broaden out beyond 12 to 15-year-olds. Thanks a ton to everyone who has watched this, and I hope you enjoyed it. See you guys again sometime. Peace.